Hi, this is Abul Kalam. Today we are going to learn nonverbal reasoning, part 1. The first figure given to us, what is nonverbal reasoning? Without any words, okay, any sentence, any words. So how to do this? Just observe how the elements or numbers or alphabets or symbols, they move. For example, hopefully what we will do is, just we will read diagonally, cat, rat, tin, kin, nap or pan, damn or mad, mid or dim, win, like that we will read. But it is waste of time. Instead of that, what would be better is just observe the middle alphabet. Here A, here I. Here A, here I. So first A, I, A, I. So next figure should start with A. How many options are there in the middle with A? So either second option or third option. This is what I am following from my first slide. Okay, so either second option or third option is the answer. So we have concluded. So first option and second option, fourth option are wrong. Now what, when you observe one more simple logic here, this, it ends with T, it starts with T. It ends with N, here ends, starts with N. It ends with M, it starts with M. Here it ends with N, so it should start with N. So which option starts with N? Second option. So second option is the right answer. Starts with N. Okay, this is the right answer. Shall we go to the next? Yeah. ID23, YP45, WJ67. Hopefully you would have got idea just seeing the blank here. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. What we have to do is, what figure will come next? Okay, what is the next figure? You have to choose one from the answer figure. So how to do this? Just you would have got idea, 8, 9 should come. So this is also 8, 9, this is also 8, 9, this is also 8, 9. Surely fourth option is wrong, because fourth option they are given 9, 8. Surely fourth option wrong, but now out of first three, someone is with anyone is right. Okay, which one is correct? For example, what is the value of D? D is 4. Okay, what is the value of I? 9. So diagonally this is 2 square, this is 3 square. Okay, D is 4, diagonally this is 2 square, and I is 9, 3 square. P is 16, this is 4 square. Y is 25, 5 square. So we have to take the square of the number. So 7 after 7, 8 and 9. So what is the diagonal? This should be 64. This should be 9 square is 81. Here 8 square is 64. Now what is the 64th alphabet? Since we know there are only 26 alphabets, divide that 64 divided by 26. 64 divided by 26, 26 twos are 52, so balance 12. So here 12th alphabet should be L. So 12th alphabet is L. Which option is L? This one is L. So third option is correct. 8 square 64. This alone is L. 9 square 81 will be C. Okay. Shall we go to the next question? Okay. Actually, I want to start with this, but since I have given introduction with some other, this is a often repeated question or most common question. They go with some symbols like this, at the rate of, ampersand, dollar, okay, percentage and something like that, they will go with the figure. Okay, how to do this question? Actually, it always slightly confusion when the how they move. I'll give you a better idea how to solve this question. Just what I have done is the same, just I have not taken the answer figure, just I'm just concentrating on problem figure. So just I have written position like this, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, middle is 9. So you can understand this is 1, this is 2, this is 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 in the middle. But this particular question we have only 4. Okay, so what are the numbers available? 1 3 5 7. This is 1. So what are the numbers available? 1 3 5 7. Just take any one symbol and just follow how it goes. For example, let us take percentage. Percentage at the beginning it is 7, then it goes to 5, it goes to position 5, then it goes to the position 1, then again it goes to position 3. So from percentage, when it goes from 7 to 5, so 7 to 5, this is 2 position it has come down. Or you can diagonally, if you see this, 1 position it has come crossways. And then it has gone here up to 1. So it has gone anti-clockwise, it is going anti-clockwise 2 position. First it is moving anti-clockwise 1 position, because this is clockwise movement and this is anti-clockwise movement. So from 1 it comes to 3. You cannot go clockwise because you have started anti-clockwise. So again from here, 1, 1, 2, 3. So first this percentage goes one step anti-clockwise, then it takes two steps, then three steps, one step, two step, three step, then finally four step. So again the percentage will be in the same position. Just observe where the percentage is in the same position, either second or third. Again we will come to a conclusion, either second or third. The same way if you do with some other logic, we'll just observe the some symbols like this at the rate of and ampersand like that. If you observe the same way I said, you will finally conclude the answer third option is the answer. Okay, why? Because this everything it will be same as this, because here four movement means the same four movement means the same figure this will become will be coming here. Okay, thanks for watching this video. Kindly do remember to subscribe this channel.